Good Monday morning, meteorologist Matt Zidle here. Let me give you an update on the forecast, and I do expect the clouds will be pretty thick along the coast. We'll thin them out gradually as we get into the afternoon. Inland areas have the highest likelihood of seeing some sun during the afternoon hours, but nonetheless, temperatures pretty much holding steady, upper 20s to lower 30s. Pretty close to average for this time of the year. Now, taking a look at the bigger picture here, satellite and radar, we do have the clouds associated with low pressure. This is well to the south of New England, and it is causing some snow across southeastern Massachusetts, also parts of Rhode Island and Connecticut, but that's the nearest approach of any of this snow, as this low pressure area stays well to our south and just keeps us in the clouds again until the afternoon hours, when we'll get a clearing trend from north to south today. Out to the west, it's pretty quiet. We're still waiting for an impulse that's going to drop down to the south and could be our system for Wednesday, where we could see some snow. Otherwise, fairly quiet until then. So here's how things shape up as we look ahead. Again, quiet conditions take us into the overnight hours. Clear sky, so it will be a little bit colder. And going into the morning hours, we can expect to see the clear sky continue. So we'll start off with plenty of sun tomorrow. And I think we're going to see a lot of sun throughout the day. In fact, even by noontime and late afternoon, clear sky. Sun sets almost at 5 o'clock now. Be able to enjoy just about all of it tomorrow. So here's our storm outlook, and again, the snow with that storm system today is down to our south. We don't have to worry about it, unless your travel plans take you down to southern New England. Don't worry about snow in the forecast for today or tomorrow. Tomorrow, in fact, we see a lot of sunshine. Going to see some clouds start to increase in the Ohio Valley tomorrow. Those will work their way northeastward, and I think by the time we get into Tuesday night and Wednesday morning, those clouds work in here, and we'll get some snow in here, I think, by Wednesday morning. Probably during the commute, the snow will start, and the heaviest of the snow looks like it's going to accumulate in southern and coastal parts of the area with this low-pressure system as it tracks very near Cape Cod and then on up to the southern tip of Nova Scotia. Again, that usually is a track that bodes well for the heaviest accumulation to be along the coast and in southern areas. So here's what I expect for snowfall, an early stab at it for Wednesday. I think we could see over 8 inches of snow from mid-coast and much of Cumberland and York County. 4 to 8 inches to the north. This may include the Lewiston, Auburn area and Augusta, back into the northern parts of the Sebago Lakes region, and then into much of the mountain and foothill region. 4 to 8 inches is likely. 2 to 4 inches a little further north, perhaps near the Canadian border. Again, subject to change here because this is still 2 days out. So for today, sun gradually developing across the areas. The clouds will slowly decrease. Low to mid 30s in the south here, so really not that cold. A little cooler than over the weekend, but still a pleasant day and dry. We'll have more sunshine developing up in the north as they see the clouds thin out the soonest. And Mid-Coast Capital District, again, cloudier.